I'm delighted to be joined today for this week's RFQ with Guillaume Chaumont of Flowdesk. Guillaume, thanks so much for coming back.
Thank you so much for having me as usual.
No, it's a pleasure. So today we're going to dig into the crypto derivatives market and a little bit of market analysis. Let's start off with options. It seems like options open interest is increasing at a higher rate than maybe futures and Bitcoin market capitalization. What's driving this?
So yeah, it's really a figure that I wanted to share with you guys today, because I think it's definitely interesting what is happening right now in the option markets, of course, in addition to the regular Bitcoin spot markets. Basically, since the last time we discussed, it was a few months ago, we have seen a 3x increase of the open interest on Bitcoin options. And in the same period, we've seen only an increase of 60% of the futures open interest. So I think there are several reasons for that. The first one is that we are seeing kind of, you know, the futures markets maturing to some extent. Exchanges have launched a new range of products, whether these are, you know, futures, long-term maturity futures, coin margin futures, and also they have launched, you know, a higher range of asset classes. We have notably initiatives from FTX, which have launched perpetuals on, you know, maybe the top 20, top 50 coins. So I think like kind of right now in terms of products, this market is matured. So that's why we are not seeing such a high growth from new products releases. And at the same time, we have Bitcoin options, which are, you know, getting more and more interest. If you look only a few months ago, Deribit hit the 1 billion threshold of open interest. So that's very recent. So we are kind of seeing, I think, in my opinion, some catch up in terms of growth rates for the options. And also, you know, investors trying to have new ways of getting exposure to Bitcoin to the upside without, you know, having necessarily the risk of liquidations like we have seen on the futures.
Yeah, indeed. So, you know, the implied volatility that we're seeing during this bull run that we're experiencing at the moment is, you know, is pretty low. Is this also a sign that the market's maturing?
Yes, I think it's another sign, and particularly a very, very interesting one. So, you know, I mean, we've all been kind of surprised by this bull run where we've seen almost 100% increase with very tiny pullbacks. You know, only yesterday morning we had a 4-5% retracement, but this is very unusual. And I think that there are several reasons for that, and I'll try to speak about two today. The first one is that this market is less retail driven than the previous one. I mean, it's not today that we have Bitcoin hitting the news about new all-time high. It's not today that we have our relatives calling us, yeah, I want to invest in Bitcoin. It will happen probably later when Bitcoin is at the 50K mark. But still here, it seems that market watchers witness that more institutionals are getting into the market, and they are using spot markets to do that. By the way, so I think that that's one of the explanation. The other thing that I see is that, you know, historically speaking, particularly the last year, particularly during the March crash, we had a huge impact of derivatives on spot markets with, you know, strong liquidations, things like this, retail participants investing up to 100x leverage, and I think that this market is being a lot, you know, more rationalized with more regulation. If you look at the BitMEX event, it's very interesting. Recently, their share went from 25% a few months ago to only 10% today. So that's also an explanation why we see less liquidation and, as a result, less volatility. And overall, I believe it's just, you know, an overall trend we've been seeing for the past years. If you look back in 2017, the 1 month at the money implied volatility went as high as 150%, and it has only been going down since. And today, the highest value that we have seen in this bull run is slightly above 70%. So that is extremely low. Probably it will go a bit higher, especially when the markets start to retrace. But still, it's a very positive sign that, you know, markets are being more rationalized. And I think that's very positive, especially for the next waves of volatility product that will come next.
Yeah, indeed. So we're also seeing the emergence of new actors releasing the next generation of volatility products, variant swaps, VX, et cetera. How does this impact the creation of more complex structured crypto products on the horizon?
So yes, you are definitely right. What I think is very interesting is that for all the reasons that we have discussed, we are now seeing new products that are created, that are being created, new volatility products. And that's why today I'm very excited to share with you guys this new variant swap that is launched on the Xena exchange. So it's a typical variant swap that allows you to bet on volatility by exchanging the realized volatility against the implied one. It's a monthly contract, typical contract, and we are Flowdesk providing the liquidity for that contract with a very interesting spread that is comparable to what you would find on other exchanges like Deribit. So that contract is traded on Xena. What is interesting about Xena is that they have reduced counterparty risk, if not neutralized, thanks to the off-exchange settlement provided by Clearloop. And they offer also other interesting products with quite interesting competitive fees. So yeah, I think it's only the beginning, you know, of this new wave of products. Also VIX is along the way. That will be like the final vanilla products that will allow to create the structured products that are definitely needed to reach a higher adoptions, particularly from professionals and institutionals. So yeah, we look forward to that, and we will see how it goes.
Brilliant. Last question. We are hovering around a Bitcoin crisis about 18,000 USD today. Where is it going? Is it going up? Are we going to hit 20 by the end of the year?
So it's very difficult, you know, to take a honest and intuitive decision on that. What I can tell you, however, is that if you look at the options, the implied probability on the options of hitting 20K before the end of the year is slightly above 30%. So I think, as far as I'm concerned, that there is definitely a good chance that we get there eventually. When we are there, probably, you know, we will see some pullback and we will have a few weeks of, you know, of prices hovering around. But if I had to take a personal bet, I think we'll get there. And looking at the current market, which is, you know, very fast, very directional, I think it could happen definitely sooner than later.
Brilliant. It's always a pleasure to have you. Thanks so much for coming back this week.
Thank you so much. It's a pleasure for me as well.